प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन.
व्हाट वी शुड कॉल?
प्रोटोप्लाज्म.
आई हैव स्टडीड दैट. आई हैव टॉट यू. करेक्ट आर नॉट?
प्रोटोप्लाज्म. यू हैव टॉट यू.
The cell membrane. What is the use of the cell membrane? It will protect. It will protect and also give the shape to the cell. Correct. And also it will controls the movement of the substances. That is what the function of cell membrane. It will controls the movement of substances into the cell and out of the cell. That is what we have studied regarding cell membrane. Is there any doubt? Anybody ask? So now later comes to here. In last before class we have studied what is cytoplasm. So as we know that cytoplasm means what? A jelly like substance. Correct or not? A transparent.
Transparent jelly.
Present between two substances. What is that? Outer membrane called as cell membrane, and inside middle some part is called as, what is that called as?
Nucleus.
Nucleus. So between this nucleus and the cell membrane or plasma membrane, we have a jelly like substance, which is a transparent and jelly like substance, which contains so many other parts of the cells like Golgi bodies, mitochondria, ribosomes, like other organelles of the cells. That is what we should call as cytoplasm. Understand, Shruti? Is it yes or no ready? Respond me.
Okay.
What is the use of this? What is the use of this cytoplasm, Ra? Most of the reactions, every chemical reaction, what will happen? Every chemical
reaction, a chemical factory of the cell,
will takes place in this cytoplasm, and that is why this is called as what? It is a kind of one word we can call it as chemical factory. Have you remembered? Cytoplasm is known as, cytoplasm is known as what? Chemical factory of a cell, because every reaction has been carried in there only. So that is why cytoplasm is known as what? Ready?
Chemical factory of,
because synthesis of energy and storage of energy, everything has been takes place here itself. So that is why we can say that. Yes or no? So most of these chemical reactions which keep the cell alive takes place in the cytoplasm. That is why we can say cytoplasm of a cell has, understand, is a chemical factory of the cell, we can say. So this cytoplasm only contains a very, very tiny structures. That tiny structures only we used to call as what? It also contains organelles, a tiny structures which contains in this. That is only we used to call it as organelles. So these organelles like mitochondria, Golgi blades, next one is what? Ribosomes. This is all. Even nucleus is also a part of it. That is all we will study in the higher classes. Now it's not required. And if you go to the plant cells, they also contains what? This cytoplasm also contains what? Which is useful for photosynthesis reaction. Not animal cells, only plant cells. What is that called as, Johan? Ready? Cytoplasm. Have you remembered? Cytoplasm. Understand, Ra? So these organelles, in these organelles, only plant cells contains what? Extra. Plant cells contains big vacuoles. Yes or no? Big vacuoles. And as well as it contains cytoplasm. So cytoplasm means contains what, Johan? Cytoplasm what? What is that? What is that called as?
Chloroplast.
Understanding, sorry. Contains chloroplast. So chloroplast. Chloroplast, the cytoplasm, big vacuoles, and the cytoplasm contains chloroplast. What? Chloroplast contains chlorophyll. Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Chlorophyll.
Useful in which reaction? Photosynthesis. Photosynthesis reaction. This is all what we should study in the last class. Now let us come to the third part of the cells, like plant cell or animal cell, both we can say. That is only called as what? What is that? A mid of the cell, which is big inside.
Nucleus.
What we should call? Nucleus. What is nucleus and how it is present in plant cells and as well as animal cells? Shall we start now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Ready? Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Let us discuss here. As we know that, nucleus is one of the cell organelle which is present in very large in size in the middle. Yes, sir. No? So,
yes, sir.
This nucleus is a large spherical organelle, spherical, which is looks like a spherical, spherical organelle present in all the cells. It is not that plant cell, it is not that animal cell. Every cell of the plant and animal, both they contains this plant cell, this one. That is what we can say, that what? What we can say?
Nucleus.
So nucleus is a large spherical organelle present in all the cells. In animal cells, nucleus lies in the center of the cell, whereas in plant cells, if we'll take, the nucleus may be on the periphery, means in the sense of near the edge of the cell it is present. I will show you the both plants and animal cell. But in animal cell, where the nucleus is present, Ra? Exactly in the? Exactly. Middle it is present, but in a plant cell, maybe it is present in the, understanding, few, it is not confirmed, it is present in the peripheral side, so means in the sense of what? Towards to the wall. Have you noticed it here? Anybody please tell me. Have you noticed it here? It is called as plant cell. So nucleus, this is called as nucleus. So nucleus is present in exactly middle or peripheral side?
Peripheral side.
That is what you have to remember. This is animal cell. So in the animal cell, exactly it is in what? Spherical shape. Also it is in what? It is exactly in middle. Yes or no? Please tell me. So that is what you have to remember. So in animal cells, nucleus lies in the center of the cell. Center of the cell. That is what you have to remember. So in animal cell, where the nucleus is lies, Ra?
Center.
Understand, center of the cell, and as well as plants, if it comes to the plants, where it will lies? It will lies at the periphery, means the sense of near the edge. Near the edge, what is the word we used to use vocabulary? Shruti?
Periphery.
Periphery. P-E-R-I-P-H-E-R-Y. P-E-R-I. 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 P-H-E-R-Y. Periphery means a side, understanding, along the side of it. That is what you have to remember. Near the edge or near the side, we can say. Near the edge. Near the edge or we can say side. Please note it down. Very, very important. In which one, Ra? Plant cells. But in both the places, how it looks, Ra? It is a very big size of organelle. Very big size of organelle. Which is present in what? Present in every plant cell and animal cell.
Yes, sir.
What is the shape of it? Shape of it? Spherical. Spherical shape. Do you understand, all of you?
Sir, it is like brain. No, sir. In book, it is given as brain of
it. Like a brain. It is the nucleus is the most important one of every nucleus, every cell. That is what I have to say. Yes. So if we'll take, nucleus is the largest organelle in a cell. So this nucleus can be...
Sir, in vacuole?
Vacuoles are present, but vacuoles are not present in every cell, correct? Do you understand?
Yes,
that is why we are not...
Yes,
if vacuoles are present in both the cells, then we can say vacuoles are the biggest organelles. But vacuoles are present in only in what? Only in
plant cells.
That is why we won't talk about it. Do you understand? Even though they are big about it. Only we'll come back, animal cells and plant cells. Understand? Together. So both nucleus, and this is the one of the biggest organelle in the cell. That is why we can say nucleus is the largest organ in the cell. That's all. Organelle in the cell. Okay, Johan? Now, if you'll consider, this nucleus, understand, can be stained and seen easily with the help of a microscope. Easily we can see with a color, like a, some using, a, like with the help of microscope, easily we can notice this nucleus. Why? Because it is very, very...
Can we see it in naked eye, sir?
Yeah, with not naked eye, with a microscope. Microscope is we are seeing through the lens only, correct? Yes, it is very large in size, so that easily we can see with the help of a microscope. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
You suppose if you want to see ribosomes, chromosomes and all, you have to see most even more powerful microscopes. But nucleus is a very big in size, big organelle, so that we can easily see with the help of microscope. That is what I am saying. Do you understand?
A simple microscope, sir. Normal microscope.
Now, let us see. This nucleus is separated from the cytoplasm by another membrane which we used to call as nuclear membrane. What we should call?
Nuclear membrane.
Because you see, this dots is called as what? What is this dots called as, Ruti? We used to call
that
cytoplasm. How the cell to cell has been separated by cell membrane. Correct or not? Each one cell to another cell they have been separated by cell membrane. Same way, cytoplasm and the nucleus has been separated by another kind of membrane. That is only we should call as what?
Nuclear membrane.
What we should call?
Nuclear membrane.
So you can see here also, both the places nuclear membrane is there. Reddy, are you there? So this black color.
Sir, the mic is not working, sir.
This is only called as nuclear membrane. What is the use of nuclear membrane, Johan?
Which sir, is it separates cytoplasm and nucleus.
Cytoplasm and nucleus, because cytoplasm is a jelly-like substance and nucleus contains some other substances, so it will prevent the mixing of that. Correct or not? That is what you have remember. Now, sir, what is the importance of nucleus? Why the nucleus is having much priority means? All of you remember, nucleus only controls all the activities of the cell. So that is why we can say nucleus is present in every cell, animal cell or plant cell, doesn't matter. Nucleus is present at every cell because of what? Only it will controls what? All the activities. It will controls the all the activities of the cells. That is why every cell contains what?
Nucleus.
That is only controls the all the activities of cell. That is why every cell contains what?
Nucleus.
Yes, that is what you have to remember. Understand, Shruti?
Yes, sir.
That is also important point. Nucleus controls all the activities of cell. Now you can comes to here. Let us comes to the qualities. So the transmission, as we know that the new cells will come from where, Johan? Reddy? New cells come from pre-existing living cells only. So new cells will come from pre-existing living cells. Existing living cells. So now here, as we know that like a binary fission, we can say one cell is going to splitting into two cells. Is it yes or no? Like slowly it will be separating it. Then how the cells are transforming? Either the body cells, suppose if you take my body cells, my future cells also should contain the same characteristics. Correct or not? What are the characteristics I'm having? Then how it is happening? How this characteristics is transforming from parents to the offsprings is because of this nucleus only. Do you understanding all of you? So nucleus contains something that is only which to call as chromosomes. What we should call?
Chromosomes.
Which is called the thread-like structure.
What am I?
Thread-like structure.
Yeah, thread-like structure. So that is what we have to use one word also here. You may observe here, inside, have you noticed it like a snakes? Johan, ready?
Yes, sir.
No, this is called as chromosomes, which will be useful in our plant. You can see more clearly pink color animal cell.
So divide it will be changes to rod like structures, sir.
Yes, this is only called as chromosomes. So these chromosomes, remember, these chromosomes we used to call as chromatin. Chromatin forms chromosomes, means that part is called as chromatin and they contains what? Chromosomes. So these chromosomes only, both plant cells and animal cells, only will useful in transformation of characteristics from parents to their offsprings. Understand all of you? Transformation of characteristics, like qualities. Do you understand? Transformation of characteristics are qualities from umra, from parents cells
to parents
to their offsprings. Their offsprings is done by whom? Is done by nucleus only. Done by nucleus. So how the nucleus means? So this process of transformation of, we have a one thing, I think you may have studied from the school side. That is the transformation of these characteristics or offsprings from the parents to the offspring. Sorry, parents to the offsprings, we used to call with some name, which will start with the I. Gene. Anybody say? Ready?
Gene.
No.
Gene.
genes is different thing. These chromosomes only we used to call as genes. That process is called as, we have something name called as, which is starts with the I. Very, very important one. What is that, ready? Johan? No.
IQ?
Huh? No.
Sir, IQ?
Number. That is only called as inheritance. What we used to call?
Inheritance.
You don't know.
Don't know, sir.
Inheritance. Very, very important one. Forever. Ask your sister Johan. She will say. Inheritance. Understand? So
okay,
what?
Sir.
Inheritance. Very, very important one. So whatever the parents still having characteristics, inheritance, please note it down. Inheritance, I-N-H-E-R, inheritance, T-A-N-C-E, I-N-H-E-R-I-T-A-N-C-E. Understand, Johan? I-N-H-E-R-I-T-A-N-C-E. What is this inheritance means? Remember, these characteristics, whatever the parents having, the transformation of these characteristics are qualities from parents to offsprings. Offsprings is only called as what?
Inheritance.
Understand? Please note it down. Write it. Inheritance. The transmission or transformation, you can write. Transmission is better. Transmission is the correct word. The transmission. Ready? Are you writing ready? The transmission of characteristics are also, we can call it as what, Shruti? Qualities from parents to their offsprings is called, what is it called, Ra?
Inheritance.
So this is who is helping for this inheritance?
The chromosomes.
Nucleus.
Chromosomes are present where? This is what?
Nucleus.
Do you understand? Nucleus is taking place. Do you understand, Johan? That is most important. Not chromosomes. Do you know one thing?
Yes,
nucleus is always contains the chromosomes. Do you think that? No. Only during cell division only we can able to see these chromosomes. Understand, Johan? It is not coming every time. Only division is taking place, by the time only we can see the thread-like structures, that is what we should call as chromosomes. Understand? So this nucleus only plays a role in inheritance. So who is helping in this inheritance? Nucleus. Understand?
Nucleus
play a role, very important role in inheritance. Please note it down. Very, very important. That is why. So how it will take place? Let us discuss now.
Yes.
Process will take place. How inheritance will take place?
Sir, Reddy has a mic problem, sir.
Okay, no problem. Take place. Okay, Reddy, you can listen. No issues. I know that already. I have read the mail. So now, how this inheritance will take place? That is what my question. So as we know that if we'll consider every kind of plant cell and animal cell, so we can see inside the nucleus, only we can see this during cell divides, but during the cell division only we can see the thread-like structures, which we used to call as chromosomes. What we should call? Chromosomes. Chromo, C-H-R-O-M-O. Chromosomes. S-O-M-E-S. Chromosomes. Learn the spelling, ready? Johan. Chromosomes. So what is chromosomes, Shruti? The thread-like structures. What is that? Right. Nucleus contains thread-like structures. Nucleus contains thread-like structure. Thread-like structure. Called as what? Called?
Chromosomes.
Now they will ask you the question. When we can see the chromosomes? Only when we can see the chromosomes.
Sir, during the cell division.
Remember, only, write it. Bracket you can remember. Chromosomes can be seen only when the cell divides. Do you understand, Ra? Only?
Yes, sir.
When the cell divides. Write it. I think we forgot to write the definition of nucleus. Correct or not? You please write that. What is the definition of nucleus, Ruti? Nucleus is a?
The nucleus controls all the activity of the cell.
Present in all the brain of the cell. Please, that is you have to write first. Nucleus is the, here you can write. What is nucleus? Nucleus is the large organelle. Organelle present in, organelle. Which shape? Nucleus is the large organelle, large spherical organelle. Spherical organelle present in all the cells. Please note it down. Shruti, do you understand, Shruti? So, who will control the every activities of the cell?
Nucleus.
So, activities of the cell has been controlled by nucleus only, and the nucleus and cytoplasm has been separated by a membrane called as what? Nuclear membrane. That is what? Here I know it is because these two diagrams. Ask me.
Sir, I have a doubt, sir. You said nucleus controls every activities of the cell, no, sir? Cell membrane also is controlled by the nucleus.
Everything, every activities, even cytoplasm, the cytoplasm is called as a food factory, a chemical factory of a cell, correct or not? That is also done by, suppose you see, every activities of our body, who is controlling? Our brain only, correct? Yes or no? Nucleus is called as the heart of the cell. Everything, every activity of the cell has been done by nucleus only. Nucleus only will suggest to the do all the activities of this one. Then only the activities will take place done by every action. Okay, Shruti? That is why we can say nucleus.
The brain or heart of the cell, sir?
That looks like a heart of the cell. But you remember, your textbook, plant cell and animal cell diagrams are very difficult diagrams. Correct? I have seen it already. Drawing is also...
That only a drawn cell.
Yeah. You can draw these two. It is no issues. No, Sampu sir will never... It is very easy and very nice also. You can draw this one. I will send the pictures. Nobody will deduct the marks. You don't need to bother about it. Do you understand, all of you?
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Nobody will deduct marks. You don't think bad. Understand? So, and even it is simple. We don't need to make it complicated like our textbooks. Understand? Go as simple as possible. Because the things which already existed, we are not going to create it, correct? Then why we need to make it complicated?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you can go with the simple current. Okay. Nothing will happen. You can take your +1, +2 books also. The cell structure, plant structure and cell structure will be like this simple only. Is it a complicated? Check your ready. You have a brother's books, you can check it. And Johan already, your sister's book is there. Definitely it will be like this much simple only. Okay?
Okay, sir.
That is what you have to remember. So now,
okay, sir.
We are studying what? This inheritance. Correct? Most important one, Ra. So what is inheritance? What is inheritance, Shruti? Law of inheritance or inheritance? The transmission. What is that? Transmission. Characteristics or qualities from parents to their
offspring.
It's called inheritance.
This is done by what? Nucleus. Nucleus plays a role in inheritance. That is why nucleus is a very, very important one. So how this nucleus will done? How this inheritance will take place means? So this nucleus contains what? A thread-like structures, which we used to call as
chromosomes.
During
the cell division.
Cell division. Please note it down. During cell division only we can see this. Remaining time we cannot see. Do you understand, all of you? So, let us discuss how it will take place. So, these chromosomes, what we are seeing during cell division, they contains a substance which is called as unit of inheritance. That is only 4-letter word which you already said. What is that called as? 5-letter word. Actually 4-letter gene, or we should call it as genes. Correct or not? G-E-N-E-S. Do you understand, Ra? So these chromosomes which you are seeing, these chromosomes contains the units of inheritance. What is that called as?
Chromosome.
So this is only we should call as genes. Have you noticed it? The genes which is passing from one parent to another parent, parent to parent, like that. That is only which to call it as genes. Yeah. You understand?
Also, so
genes contains by whom? Chromosomes. Chromosomes only contains the genes. That is why these are the units of inheritance. What we should call? Genes are called as?
Unit of inheritance.
Units of inheritance. Very, very important. Shruti, understand, you are preparing like NEET level only now onwards, because very, very useful this, all the information in class 10th, plus 1, plus 2, your NEET exams and all. Now onwards, you must have strong fundamentals. That is what I'm saying. So, even though if you are studying single part also, why I am teaching slowly? Because you must know everything. If I ask what is nucleus, everybody will say maximum 2 points. Correct or not, Johan? Nucleus is a large organelle which is looks like a spherical, which is present in every cell. That's all they will say maximum. Or else they will say nucleus is controlled all the activities of the cell. Correct? That's all. But so many points already we have studied. Animal cell nucleus is present where? Exactly at the
center.
Plant cell, where it is present?
Plant cell periphery.
It is present at the periphery. Means the sense of side of the heart, not. That is what you have to remember. But nobody knows that near the edge it is present. And so many things we know. Law of inheritance, nobody knows. Correct or not?
Yes, but in our book, they give nucleus and plant cell in middle cell.
Middle?
Yes, sir.
I don't think so, Johan.
And vacuoles at the side, sir.
Vacuoles, see, we cannot say it is a fixed cell, Johan. You remember? Vacuoles.
Yes, sir. It's a liquid, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, it is present anywhere. We cannot say it is present in particular.
Yes, sir, but the nucleus they are given middle, sir.
Wait, I will say it is not middle. You may observe, notice correctly. You are not seeing it correctly. The picture they are showing it. Plant cell, you can check it. It is close to the wall. You may notice it. It is a 3D picture. That is why they are representing it. But it's okay. No issues. But you have to remember it is exactly present at the side of the edge. Understand? It is one of the That is next inheritance. This inheritance means what? Transformation of characteristics or qualities. Now let us see this. This genes, this chromosomes contains the units of inheritance. That is what we should call it as what? Genes. Understand? So the function of chromosomes is to only, what is the use of these chromosomes means? They will transfer the characteristics of, suppose, let me take my parents to me to my children, their children to their children. Like that, the use of these chromosomes in the animals and plants, both is just to transfer the characteristics from the parents to the offspring. Through what? Through the a unit of inheritance. What we should call it as?
Unit of inheritance, genes.
Yes. So through the genes, carrying the characteristics of parents to the offsprings is only the function of whom? Function of chromosome. Do you understand, all of you? Function of chromosome. That is all. Please note it down. Are you understand, Shruti?
Yes, sir.
So chromosomes contains a unit of inheritance called as genes. So what is the function of chromosome? Ready? Function of chromosome. Johan?
Function of chromosome, cell division.
Transfer the characteristics from parents to offspring. Through
genes.
That is why this genes is called as units of inheritance, and this full process is called as what? This transformation of characteristics, what we should call?
Inheritance.
Do you understanding?
Sir, cell division.
Ready?
Yes, sir.
Also, you observe these nucleus also they contains a tiny round structures. You may observe in the picture, both the plant cell and animal cell, in the nucleus inside we have a round structures. All of you observe, what is this called as? This round structures, can you able to see, Johan, Shruti?
Yes, sir.
Nucleus.
Round structures. Yes, yes. The mitochondria.
Yeah, have you noticed it?
The nucleus.
Round structures. This is only called as nucleolus. What you should call? Nucleolus. Understand, Shruti?
Nucleolus.
I am representing you. Very, very important part. This is only called as what? nucleolus. Please put it down. That is a very important one. So that is the spherical one, a spherical like a rod-like structures which are present inside. That is only called as nucleolus, right?
The function of nucleolus.
You just wait. So the nucleolus, right? Nucleus also contains a tiny round structure. Nucleus also contains tiny round structure. Nucleus also contains a tiny round structure. Is called what? Is called nucleolus.
Nucleolus.
Nucleolus, right. N-U-C-L-E-O. N-U-C-L-E-O. Nucleolus, L-U-S. Nucleolus. So these nucleolus, if you'll observe little carefully with a microscope, we can directly see. Do you understand, Johan? We can see under the high magnifying power, not normal microscope, little bit magnifying, highly magnifying power of microscope if you use, we can easily see it. Do you understand? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
That is what you have to remember. If you see with a little bit highly magnifying microscope, we can use to observe this nucleolus. So now, what is this function?
I'm just talking, sir.
That is what Johan is asking. But for your level, and even if I'll say nucleolus is one of the most important one in the nucleus, more than these chromosomes, but we don't need to study here. Because we don't have use of the studying the nucleus, functioning of nucleolus at this level. We'll study in the plus two. So in 3 years, it won't come anywhere. What is the functioning of nucleolus? So at that level, we'll study. In the higher classes, we'll study the functioning of nucleolus. Just you have to notice the tiny round structures present in the nucleus is only called as what? Nucleolus.
Nucleolus.
That is what you have to remember. We'll study in the higher classes. Now, let us come to here. As we know that this nucleus contains two things now. What is that? Chromosomes and as well as?
Chromosomes
and nucleolus. So, these chromosomes and nucleolus is bounded by a membrane called as. What is that membrane called as? Which is separating
nuclear membrane.
Cell membranes, which is separating from what is that called as? Cytoplasm and the nucleus.
Cytoplasm and nucleus.
That is what we
should call
nuclear membrane. That is, understand all of you? Yes or no? Nuclear.
Yes,
sir.
Nuclear membrane. Please note it down. Nuclear membrane. What is that? What is the nuclear membrane?
The divide cytoplasm and nucleus.
That is, you write it. Chromosomes. Chromosomes and nucleolus is covered by a membrane which separate cytoplasm
and the nucleus.
Cytoplasm and the nucleus is called nuclear membrane. Do you understand, Andy? Nuclear membrane. That is what you have to remember. So, and also you remember, like cell membrane, this nuclear membrane also having tiny pores. What is the use of these tiny pores? You may observe. Tiny pores, like cell membrane.
Mm-hmm.
It allows the exchange of movement of the substances into the cell and out to the cell. Has been done by cell membrane.
Yes, sir. Oxygen and
nucleus. This nucleus, understanding? This nuclear membrane also having a tiny pores of that. What is the use of that? It is exchange of materials. Understand? It is present between where? Cytoplasm and the nucleus. Correct or not?
Yes.
Whatever the cytoplasm, so many reactions will take place. That is why we can say that it is a chemical factory of cell. Correct or not? Chemical factory.
Yes.
If the nucleus want to align, it is also need to absorb the so many substances and it needs to send some substances outside. Correct or not? So, because of that, to get the substances from the cytoplasm, understand, this nucleus also contains a tiny pores. What is the use of the tiny pores? What is the use of the tiny pores?
Tiny pores, exchange of materials.
From cytoplasm. From cytoplasm. Like the cell membrane. Cell membrane from the outside. That are not. From outside. From outside the cell. Exchange of substances from one cell to another cell or from somewhere. That is what it is having tiny pores. You understanding all of you? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
This nuclear membrane has a tiny pores for the exchange of materials with the cytoplasm. That is what, understanding, we used to call it as pores of the cytoplasm. There is no name of it. We have to just remember nuclear membrane is also contains tiny pores like cell membrane for exchanging of materials with the cytoplasm. With the cytoplasm. Do you understand all of you?
Yes, sir.
And
yes, sir.
Nucleus. Coming to this nucleus, this nucleus does not having, do not have, remember all of you, this nucleus is not present in one kind of cells which is present in our body, like all the animals, not the plants. That is what we can say, red blood cells. What is that, Ra? What is that? Red blood cells. Please remember,
red blood cells
do not have a nucleus. Please, that is the only cells which does not contain nucleus. That is also they will ask you. Which of the cells does
and
not?
And which will control the activity here in RBC?
Hemoglobin. They control hemoglobin and they will be functioning without nucleus itself. Do you understand? They contain a pigment called as hemoglobin, which will exchange the gaseous. Understand, Johan? Which will allow the exchange of gaseous and all. That is. So only cells which does not contain nucleus. What is that, Ra? Not contain nucleus.
Contain nucleus, RBC.
Nucleus is called as is RBC. So what is RBC full form? Red blood cells. Red blood cells. Please note it down. Red blood cells. Actually, cells, not corpuscles, we can call. What we should call, Johan? Red blood corpuscles. Oh. Corpuscles. But normally we'll study red blood cells. We have to study white blood corpuscles, red blood corpuscles. 10th class we will study corpuscles. But now you can study RBC. No issues.